Good afternoon, everybody. Today I'm going to present about my research presentation. So this is about Sri Lankan civil war effect for the civil society. This is the content of my presentation: introduction, research objective, discussion, conclusion, and references. First of all, under the introduction part, I would like to give some explanation about Sri Lankan civil war. It started in 1983, and that conflict arose due to the ethnic tension between the Tamil and Sinhala people. And this case were more complex, and it's happened in large part of the Sri Lanka, especially north and east part of the Sri Lanka. And 80,000 to 100,000 people were killed during that time period, and also not only killing, but also there are some injuries, bombing, like this. So after 25 years, in 2009, NTT eradicated by the government with directions, and during that 25 years, the war created adequate harmful effects for population, environment, and social and economic condition in Sri Lanka. And and also that war condition leads to leads to damage human rights, health, education, security, and destroys shelter of the people, civil people. So that's very dangerous. That was very dangerous time period in Sri Lankan, for Sri Lankan people. And there are some direct and indirect effects. When considered about the direct effect from civil war for civil society, like killing, injuring, and harming to civilian people in society. And when considered about the indirect effects due to that killing, injuring, and harming to civil society, that indirect effect can were raised. Especially, it's leaded to damage health and services sectors, and also especially tourism industry. Then that whole situation leads to enhanced mortality and mobility of the civil people. Then I would like to give some introduction about Millennium Development Goals. Actually, civil war leads to create more obstacles for Millennium Development Goals, especially for the primary education and gender equality within the education system. And apart from that, it's focused on the world hunger, poverty, inadequate shelter, and diseases. When considered about the overall, both goals are developed to success. The sustainability of environment and institutional, economic, and social. So this is the research objective. That report illustrates how to affect civil war in Sri Lanka for its civil society, as economically and socially. And under the discussion part, I would like to explain about civil war condition effect for economic condition of the society. During the civil war condition, most of the production resources and activities were damaged. So army purpose expenditure was increased by the government. That condition leads to decline the economic growth, and also expenses reduction on other public needs such as health and infrastructure facilities, service sector. And actually more economic reduction created from direct damaging of physical infrastructure facilities such as telecommunication, airport, road, and bridge. That directly affect to communication sector, agriculture sector, transportation, and administration sector. And these are some memorized Lanka because Tamil tiger attacked for the civil people, and there are some catastrophic effect from that of the Tamil tiger. In the late 1990, they repeatedly tiger suicide bombers attack in capital cities, especially Colombo and other southern cities of the Sri Lanka, and they hit the central bank in Colombo, and the Sri Lankan World Trade Center. It's also situated in Colombo, it's a capital city in Sri Lanka. And not only that, but also they hit for the religious places, especially the Buddhist places in Sri Lanka. As example, Temple of Truth Relic in Kandy. You can see that damage via the images. And third one is in July 2001, tiger suicide attack on the Bandar Nayak International Airport, and destroy 8 military jets, 4 airlines, leader to reduce Sri Lankan's tourism industry. And second one is civil law affecting for forced migration of people. Actually, most of the Sri Lankan civilian migrated internally and externally. So, due to the fear of missing their families and their lives. And external displacement means people forced out into another country as a refugees. And in Sri Lanka during that war period, approximately around 100,000 people externally migrated to India, UK, Canada, and Australia like countries, and around 800,000 all ethnic group people internally migrate, especially from north and east part of the Sri Lanka. It's an initial internal migrate condition. And third one is civil war effect to the children. And mostly north part of the Sri Lankan children were affected with high risk of poor health care, malnutrition, and forced migration, and education, and bombing and the sexual violence, especially the children. UNICEF, according to the data of the UNICEF that evaluated, there were 900,000 children in Northeast province. They had been extremely influenced by civil war, like food, lack of food, shelter, education, and from direct injuries. And civil war effect for children education. War condition can affect the damage of education system via losing the people, especially students and teachers, because always they attack for the schools. They kill the students, they kill the teachers of the school. So that condition, they attack the infrastructure facilities and also that education of the children that affected by the increasing of military expenditure that led to effectual reduction of education expenditure. And according to the education data of UNESCO organization indicated that both expenditure and enrollment of education decreased during that war period because of military expenditure. It's more. And before war situation, the literacy rate of children it was over 80%, and the percentage of attending school children up to grade 5 was over 90%. According to the Education Ministry data, that indicated that 75,000 students enrolled in primary school. And during war period, it's reduced to 40,000 to 50,000. So as a result of war, around 1 to 3 of children did not attend school in especially war affected areas such as east and north part of the Sri Lanka. And civil war condition affect on gender. Actually, civil war negatively affect for all gender, men, women, children, especially men and women, because they are vulnerable for the, especially for the sexual violence during that time period. And because of the gender inequality and breaking down of social network, that vulnerable for the sexual violence condition. And when considered about the sexual violence condition during that war period, the variation of sexual violence condition was increased than the peacetime, and the individual sexual preference differ in the peacetime than the wartime. So there are some reasons for variation of that sexual violence in wartime. First one is, during the war period, social regulatory mechanism were frequently damaged than peacetime. And there is a biological reason, because during the wartime, testosterone level is high during wartime due to the aggression. And then I'm going to the next slide, civil war effect to mental health. So especially children were suffered from some mental illnesses like trauma. And according to the survey that was conducted from Tamil school children who exposed to civil war condition in northeast province of Sri Lanka, indicated that 19% to 25% children were suffered from post-traumatic stress disorders. And the irregular internal and external displacement also contribute to develop high risk of long-term mental disorders. And also physical trauma condition mainly resulted via directly attacked by bombs and physical injuries. This is the conclusion of my presentation. And the civil war can affect society as a long term when after ending of the war. And the economic condition can be held down for several years because of the government has to invest a lot of money for the military purpose without spending money for the development of infrastructure facilities and social services. And that condition leads to impoverishment of poor society. And according to my point of view, that civil war is not good for whole world, because of each have more impact for environment, social, economic condition of the country. Thank you. This is the end.